My name is Greg Stelter. I'm a lieutenant with the City of Oshkosh Fire Department. We are here at Oshkosh Fire Department Station 15. Today we're going to be talking about our Husky Airboat. This boat is owned by the Winnebago County Sheriff's Department, but primarily operated by the City of Oshkosh Fire Department. We use this airboat to respond to rescue calls during the winter months on Lake Winnebago when we have to go across ice to get people falling through the ice. This boat does not handle like a regular boat. It is a fan boat, so that means you don't have reverse or sudden braking abilities. Basically have to do a lot of sliding around to get where you want to go, and ice and wind conditions can change how the boat handles. The most important part about this boat is that it can travel either on solid ice or in water and is able to transition between those two types of surfaces. So when we have to approach open water from a solid ice sheet, we simply slow down and let the boat basically slide into the water. We can then use the fan to propel the boat and the rudders to steer it. When we have to get back onto the ice, we simply nose the boat up to the edge of the ice sheet and apply a lot of throttle, and the fan pushes the boat right back up onto the ice. This boat was built in 2004 by Husky Airboats. It has a 19-foot long hull and is 23 feet overall. It has a 5.7-liter V8 engine that is rated at 355 horsepower, weighs 2,900 pounds empty, and can transport 1,200 pounds of personnel or equipment. Most boats that have a rigid hull have fiberglass on the bottom and then braces inside the boat called stringers. This boat does not have that because of the punishment it takes traveling over broken ice and many surfaces. So this boat uses a bonded Kevlar hull material with a system of airbags that are actually inflated to provide internal support. That allows the boat to flex without cracking or breaking. The Winnebago system is very popular with recreational users in the winter, but there are many hazards too. The ice can be thin in the early part of the season or the late part of the season, and the lake always has a network of large cracks that have to be crossed. It's very easy for people to lose their position and fall through these hazardous areas. That's why it's important for us to have a response vehicle that can get to those areas. However, it's important to say the ice is never 100% safe on this system, so we encourage anybody who's going to use this system that's not familiar with it to contact local bait stores or the fishing clubs to find out what is safe and what is not safe to do on the lake. If you do fall through, it's important that you have your cell phone with you. If you call 911, your cell phone will transmit a signal that our dispatch center can use to locate you on the ice. We then turn that signal into GPS coordinates so that we can find you and get to you as quickly as possible. Be sure to stay safe on the ice. We'd much rather have you be high and dry and enjoying ice fishing than in a life-threatening situation.